within the tenets of the Rastafari tribe. We take just like I was explaining, we take this lamb's bread, this ganja, and so to be a sacrament, sacramental part of our whole history.
Why it is such an important part or an integral part of the Nyabingi order is that, you know, the ritual of marijuana, it harmonizes all the Rastafari temples. It brings us in one. It opens our it opens our chakra, it opens our third eye, you know. It creates the essence, or the sweet savor or perfume that we offer unto the Most High. So hence the reason, my brother, again, I wish to tell you that marijuana is a sacred part of the Rastafari ritual. Hence the reason why today the Rastafari throughout the entire Caribbean, not only in Trinidad, is fighting for the sacramental rights of the Rastafari. For it is based upon our humanitarian rights. For over 40 years, Rastafari had been persecuted cruelly. Rastafari had been imprisoned unlawfully, all because of their holy sacramental rights as a Rastaman. We do not advocate for or use marijuana for recreational purposes. We use marijuana as a healing. We use marijuana to harmonize and bring the essence and perfume and sweet savor unto our Godhead, Haile I, Selassie I, Rastafari.
When the system of society makes it a criminal, illegal, what it does is make people who are actually not criminals into criminals and gives them like a criminal record and stuff like that, and people are not able to travel and stuff like that. And I find those things to be very unjust. I think the laws should not prevail as to what they should do with them own self then. As long, like, for example, if you steal from someone, you have offended somebody else. If you rape someone, you have offended somebody else. Murder and all these different things, you have offended someone else. But in reference to the use of marijuana and other things, I wouldn't like to name them right now, but let me keep it on the marijuana. In reference to the use of marijuana, it's a personal yeah, so I don't see where the laws should have anything to do with that. So if you have your own sovereignty, you should be able to, practice your religion, pull your ganja, as long as you don't offend the rest of the world.
It has affected the Rastafari community because look at it. Our hands and foots are free from change. But the system has us in shackles based upon marijuana. Because so many Rastafari brothers and sisters had lost their family. Families have just been disintegrated. All because of the simple use of the herb, which is an integral part of Rastafari ritual, which is an integral part of Rastafari harmonization in oneness with the Godhead, Haile I, Selassie I, King Rastafari. So again, we say that over the 40 years, Rastafari had paid, we had paid our dues. And based on our humanitarian rights, you know, based on our humanitarian rights, it is time that we've been given our sacramental rights to use our herb free and bring the sweet savour to our Godhead Haile Selassie I King Rastafari. We need our sacramental rights so that our children can enjoy, you know, the fullness of the family. For in Rastafari, the family is very sacred, very, very sacred. And again, I say, there are those who drink their rum, there are those who use their tobacco, but Rastafari abstain from strong drinks, wine, and all these things. And our herb is part of our ritual.
And while the denominations have intricate differences, such as their view of Selassie, their manner of worship, and their choice of music, they have more in common than not. One commonality is their sacrament, marijuana. I met up with another Rasta leader, Bobo Shanti High Priest Ainsley of Zion, at a different coronation celebration, this one in Digo Martin, to get another perspective. Calling for unity, he believed the liberalization of Rastas lies in Rastas themselves.
All society have their sedatives, which part a man come home from work, he take a martini, according to them, well, I guess that's acceptable, or a man drink a wine. Well, the Rasta man come and say, well, no, you know, we go burn a draw herb, or we go eat a draw herb, or we go drink some herb tea, according to how you want to partake of it. And the meditation, what it get, that inner you, what it rise up in you. It's not a violent you, it always rises up the God in you. It always rises up the compassion in you, the empathy in you, you know. These are the kind of things what the herb, you know, bring out of a man. You know, a man want to seek, a man want to know, a man want to understand, you know. So we see this as a plus for humanity, even especially at this time, because we see a lot of the way what humanity is pushing or what humanity is peddling is a lot of violence, you know what I mean? A lot of, you know, strictly violence, gore, bloody, you know, heartless, cold, you know what I mean? So the herb is directly the opposite of that, you know, the empathy, you know, the love of the compassion of humanity, because we are in a critical stage right now where our life is so cheap. I told a man already, say, since you are against it, so your honor, why don't you lock up the man who made the seeds? And he thought I was being rude. But really, we didn't have nothing to do with it, my lord. We came at all the plants of the earth is before mankind. So Almighty God knew what he was doing when he put that down on the earth. You know, so how come it is definitely a society thing where they is flexing the power, because the same law that is telling us it's illegal is the same law that had told us it was illegal for we to learn to read.
Dread not the dread now. Dread like Congo Bongo. Not the dread like in a Babylon. A dread like Congo Bongo. Children, get your culture.